So you want to build something wearable, but you're not sure how to power it? You're in luck. Today, I'm going to help you pick the best battery for your wearable electronics project. First, it's important to know how much power your circuit uses. You can look up the maximum current draw of each component and add them together. Then, pick a battery that matches or exceeds your amperage needs. This 1.5-volt rechargeable AAA battery stores 750 milliamp hours, which means it can theoretically output 750 milliamps for an hour, or half that much current for twice as long. If you have three in a battery pack, it can give you three times that voltage, 4.5 volts, at the same 750 milliamps. My Flora, GPS, and 8 NeoPixels, on blue only, total up to 210 milliamps of current draw. So this three AAA pack can easily run the project for about 3 hours. In reality, your pixels are probably not on full brightness all the time, and will therefore draw less current than you calculated. This power supply overhead is a good thing and means that you're not going to overtax your battery. You could also just measure the current draw of your circuit using a benchtop power supply or a multimeter. I usually prototype my circuits on a plug-in power supply and then switch to battery power later. It's just one less thing to troubleshoot. We have several different flavors of alkaline battery holders. For most wearables, we're looking for 3 to 5 volts. So we can add up 2 to 4 double or AAA batteries at 1.5 volts each to get there. Alkaline packs are great. These batteries are easily replaceable and the hard plastic keeps everything safe. But if you're more advanced, you might like these power-dense and lightweight lithium-ion polymer rechargeable cells. These batteries come in many shapes and sizes and require a special charger to fill them up. Some are small enough to wear on earrings or other jewelry. Lithium cells are more delicate than alkaline packs and require extra care and attention to prevent from being damaged. You should never bend, crush, puncture, or otherwise abuse these batteries. I often wrap them in gaffer's tape when embedding them in projects, like here on the Neo Geo watch and in the pocket of my winter coat. Lithium batteries can get hot during charging, so they should be charged away from fabric and your body. Unplug the battery from the connector to recharge from any USB port. For Gemma projects, a slim battery holder with a built-in switch is handy. Coin cells are fairly high capacity for the size. This pack can give you about 6 volts and 250 milliamp hours. However, it can't provide tons of current for long periods of time. This pack can power a Gemma plus 3 or 4 NeoPixels for a couple hours. Pack spares in case the party runs long. Many of you ask how to power a large number of pixels on the go, like in a video jacket. And sure, you could put a 6-volt lead-acid battery in your backpack, but these days there are some lighter weight options available. For easy charging, nothing beats a pack of nickel metal hydride batteries. 3 AAs will power most projects. 4 AAs can alleviate the voltage drop that occurs over long lengths of conductive textiles. Another way to deliver juice to your power-hungry wearable is through these USB battery packs. We source them for the Raspberry Pi, but this bigger one can deliver up to 2 amps, enough to charge your iPad, and has 10,000 milliamp hours of capacity. Flora is designed to handle 2 amps through the protection diodes, so you can just plug in the pack into the USB port and it can drive up to 100 NeoPixels. We hope this helped you pick the perfect power source for your project. Check out the batteries, holders, and chargers in the Adafruit shop. And if you still have more questions, post them up in the comments. I'll answer them on our live show, Wearable Electronics with me, Becky Stern.